body, the wide body of scholarship is accepting that this is not the word of God, then why and how do people base their entire lives and their afterlife on the guidance of something that is demonstrated, you can demonstrate not to be from the Creator?
In a way, your criticisms of the Bible seem, no disrespect, but they yes. seem kind of worse than an atheist. Because the reason I say that is because it seems like that it's like you don't think that a God could allow the Bible to be put together the way it is, with all the ups and downs within it,
yes.
And people's opinions on it, whether this is true, whether that's true, this whether this author wrote it, such. It's like you don't believe that God could do that,
yes.
and actually make that book be credible.
Yes.
And I think okay. I'm kind of walking a little bit.
But brother, you know the point. But the point here is this, though, right?
Because sorry to interrupt. I'll just say this, and then I'll let you come in. Of course, it seems to me that God did that.
Yes.
To allow people's confusions of the Bible, so that the Bible would survive, yes. so that it would survive, and in the last days, the Bible. God said that the seals would be broken because the testimony, the true testimony of Jesus Christ is prophecy,
yes.
not love.
Yes. Okay, brother, look, the thing here is this, right? If the Muslims were making a claim about the Bible, that your own Christian scholarship, Christian scholarship, the wide body, the consensus of scholarship disagreed with, then you would have a point. But here we are giving you an opinion. Often that's not even our own opinion. It's the opinion of your own scholars in consensus who are saying that these are not the words of God Almighty. In fact, what they're saying is even more than worse than that. They're saying some of these are direct and deliberate fabrications. In other words, people have deliberately added things that are false. And at times there are scribal errors. And at times that things have just got lost. And this is an estimation, okay? So our claim as Muslims, it's not something that your own, you know, general consensus of scholarship doesn't agree with. Secondly, your second point is this, that to suggest that something has survived and yet it hasn't been preserved, that is not survival. Survival is something that is preserved. That's the whole point of surviving, right? Otherwise, it's just a Bible by name. If the very contents of the Bible have been changed, How does that mean it survived?
I disagree. Because like the Bible is such an important book to so many.
Yes.
And like I said, it's like you seem to think that there's no God because as though God couldn't allow the Bible to be put together the way it is. Like I said, with all the things that people think about it.
Yes. The point I'm saying to you, brother, is this. The God of mercy, the God of love for his creation would not leave them in perpetual darkness. He will always send another, always, to correct that which was going wrong. That's why Jesus was sent down. What did Jesus say? I have not come but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Why did he say that? Because he said, look, you guys are going astray, and the Father, God Almighty, has sent me to correct that which you are going astray on. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did exactly the same thing. He was then sent down to correct what the Christians and the Jews had misinterpreted, misinformed, misconstrued, fabricated, and from worshipping the only one and only true God of Abraham, they now started to worship a man who was born to Maryam, Mary. And they made him equal to God. And so Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, don't do this, you're going astray. Abraham didn't teach this, he taught to worship only the Creator. Moses, only the Creator. Jesus, peace be upon him, peace be upon all of them, only worship the Father, the Creator, attributed his miracles with the finger of God. Never said, I do of my own accord, right? Mm. It's exactly what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Allah is one, he is only, he is absolute, he is eternal, and nothing, nothing, nothing can be joined in the divinity of the Creator.